Today we present you the first in a series of tutorials, Interior Lighting in VRay. You will find a link to download the entire scene that is presented in this tutorial in the description. We are providing it in two versions, one with amateurish and bad settings and one with the correct lighting, the kind that we would do in Evermotion. The scene is in 3ds Max and VRay format, obviously. Step 1. We'll import geometry to our scene with the select lighting and cameras and open the file. Now we'll change the viewport layer. We'll choose the division into two panels. Next, we open the render setup window and we'll set our target resolution. After that, we can close the render settings and add our VRay camera. First, we select camera from our VRay tab and we position it. Press C to see the camera view. Set the position of the camera and then you can select the camera target. Our camera is too low, so we need to adjust it a little bit. And now we can select camera target and also lift it a bit. Now we'll select our camera and adjust the focal length. The default is 40 and it's too low for us. We'll change the natural 50 mm focal length. We will correct tilt and shift by choosing automatic vertical tilt. And the final adjustments to the target. Now we are ready to add our VRay sun. We can select it from the panel on the right. We can position it from the top view and we will be automatically asked to add VRay Sky. When we press yes, it will be added in the Environment and Effects tab. We can open it by pressing 8 and open the Material Editor by pressing M. Drag and drop your sky to Material Editor as an instance and choose it. Now we can tweak it. At the default, the specified sun node is off. We can manually choose which direct light is taken into consideration by VRay Sky. Now we can close Environments and Effects tab and set the position of the sun. Now we need to see what the sun does to our scene, so we need to turn on interactive production rendering. We open render setup and we assign VRay as our production renderer. VRay IPR gives us an ability to easily test lights and materials in our scene during interactive rendering. we can enable it by choosing it from the pop-up menu in the viewport. And now we can see how the sunlight affects our scene. We need to take into consideration the save frames. Our final render has a different resolution from our viewport, so we need to set the save frames to see what will fit in our final frame. We can enable save frames by choosing them from the menu in the viewport, Show save frames, or by pressing Shift and F. Now is the time to make adjustments to our render. As for now, it is too dark and it has incorrect light balance, but we'll fix it in a second. Choose your physical camera. And the first value that will change, it will be the shutter speed. Our objects are static, so changing shutter speed now will only affect how bright they are. We'll tweak this value a bit. Seems okay. But the white balance is off. The scene is too warm. We can fix it in this panel. Let's lower the Kelvin temperature to 6000. It's much better already. But we'll tweak it even more later on. The next step is to soften the shadows. To get this effect, we need to change the size of VRay Sun. As you can see in the viewport, now the shadows are much too sharp. If we want to achieve soft look, the sun needs to be bigger. We can do it by increasing the size multiplier. By increasing it to 5, you can see already that the shadow is getting smoother. But we need more, so we'll enter the 10 value and check it out. Now shadows look really nice. The next step is to tweak environment and GI settings. Press A to open Environment and Effects window, and press M to open Material Editor. We've got our VRay Sky and it controls the environment. But we will make another one to control GI only. Duplicate it by holding the Shift key. And now we can rename it. Now we can open the render setup and choose our second VRay Sky in Environment tab as GI environment. We just drag and drop it here as an instance. And now our GI environment is controlled by the second VRay Sky. This allows us to lighten the interior, but without making environment brighter. We just increase sun intensity multiplier here. We can also color correct this GI by choosing color correction map and connecting it to the node. With this map, we can desaturate our GI and remove any unnecessary tint. Now we can close it. We still have some yellowish tint, so we'll fix the white balance in the camera by changing Kelvin temperature of this scene. In a sunny day, the default temperature should be about 5600 or 5700 Kelvins. Now it's right. Now we'll discuss the Skylight portals. Skylight portals are planes that we place in the windows to speed up the rendering. When they are enabled, the render goes faster and it's less noisy. So we just select the VRay light, make a rectangle and place it in the window's openings. We tweak the size and position of our portal and then we move it towards the window, and then when it's correctly placed we can duplicate it so each window has its own VRay portal. We duplicate it as an instance because all the settings for VRay portals are the same. So in this case, we'll have four instances of VRay portals. VRay lights that are used as Skylight portals can be simple or not. There is a difference in this setting. We'll show it in a second. So we placed a magenta cylinder outside the window to show you how the settings affect the color inside. When we turn the Skylight portal off, the color of an environment leaks into the interior and it's casted onto the walls. When we use Skylight portals, much less of this color is getting in, and the render inside is much cleaner, without magenta tint. But only when we use simple option, the whole color of environment inside is ignored and the only light that is taken into consideration is the light of the GI. And GI is just VRay Sky that we already desaturated. The last part is the frame buffer. So now we're ready to make our final render. We check the resolution. We go to VRay tab and choose the image sample to progressive and render time to 0. Now we can render. We can make various tweaks in frame buffer. It's a complete post-production environment. First we'll change exposure and decrease highlight burn to make the highlight softer and not overexposed. This way we have really, really nice soft light. can also adjust the contrast a little bit. And after that, we can increase the contrast by using curves. The most common is to drag down the shadows and drag up the highlights, making an S shape, so the image pops up. We can also add lens effects. We've got a lot of light coming out from outside, so it should give us some natural bloom and glare. We can adjust it here on this tab. We can change the size and intensity of bloom, and then we can change the threshold. If the effect is too strong, we can decrease the opacity. From this moment, we can freely experiment with our render, changing toner mapping, contrast, and all other stuff that you wish. So have fun, and thanks for watching.